Oh, you look good.
It's not coming off.
How long we gotta wear this? We gotta keep this on? I don't know if I can take it off.
A funny story, actually. I used to have a crush on this man for a minute, and he had no idea. Like, he was part of a group that I sang with, and I would see him multiple times a week, every week, and really it wasn't anything that I could do about it because he was otherwise occupied, but...
Yeah, I didn't know. I never knew this lady had a crush on me at all. Like, she hit it well, and I was married at the time, so she really couldn't make it obvious, but yeah. To find that out was like mind-blowing. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we just ran into each other after my divorce, everything, and I don't know, it was definitely a connection. Like, we could feel something drawing us to each other. That day we were at a mutual friend of ours graduation party. Their child was graduating. Okay. High school, and we both ended up seated at the same table and just spent that whole evening, like, you know, chit-chatting, hanging out, laughing, enjoying the fellowship. They danced a little, and so we just, you know, had fun. It was a cool vibe. So
definitely glad to have a second chance, because I had resolved in my mind that I was content with being single, was living a single life, doing single things, you know, going and coming as I please, only thinking about myself. And so it was a bit of a transition to decide and to make the changes that, okay, I'm going to be a partnership again, you know, in a relationship with somebody and doing a couple things and thinking, no longer thinking singularly, and actually having my baby in my life. You know, it was a decision, a conscious decision that I had to make and do a little bit of work to get to the point to where we are now.
Yeah, it's been a long road. He was so single.
Yeah.
The one that I dreamed about, the one I can't live without, the one he kept for me until it was time.
Josh is a really, really kind person, always looking to see where he can help. I look at how his siblings love him. He's just really, really kind. Another word is patient, because he puts up with me.
I knew I needed to be patient with her. I learned progressively more and more. But I don't know, in my older age, I just tend to want to be more patient in life, because I realize nothing is a sprint. You know, when you're younger, you're chasing after, you're running after everything, but you realize everything takes time. You got to build something. If you're going to build something, you got to be patient with the process.
It definitely took a lot of patience, and I'm grateful that he was able to exercise that with me. And he is hilarious. He keeps me laughing, keeps other people around him laughing. And it's a good thing to have, because, you know, life can be so serious, especially we went through COVID together, and that humor has helped. You know, those long days that we're running into each other, you know, it came in handy. So, yeah.
Loving, giving, and consistent. She has a heart to share with people, like to give to people and help meet others' needs. she really cares. Like, she cares about her friends, she cares about her family, she cares about a lot of people, even though sometimes she don't act on it because I make her not. Because she be doing too much sometimes, but her heart is always there. So she's a giving person. She'll sacrifice and give you the clothes off her back. She'll give you whatever you need. She's a giving person. And she's consistent because she liked to find the groove and she liked to ride the wave. She definitely liked to find the sweet spot and just stay there as long as you can until you absolutely have to move. So that was the nicest way I could say it. I think I did you a good job.
Getting in a groove and staying in a groove.
As long as it's a good groove.
It's a good groove. Right. Yeah. I'm ride away.
Put it in the pocket.
Yeah, stay in the pocket. Oh, I was so excited to finally see him. My baby looks good anyway, but I'm just happy to celebrate today. And I love my sweetheart with all my heart.
I've been on my knees and I've been praying loud. Palms getting sweaty, my nerves feeling heavy. Holding back these tears as I see your face. I'm a lucky man, wondering how did I get you? We made it this far, and now we're standing hand in hand. Yeah. No doubts in my heart that I found the one that's heaven sent. And today is your day. You look beautiful in that dress, baby. Yeah. I fell for an angel. Only two words for me to say. I'ma say it to your face.
So, I mean, I'm looking forward to a lot in our future. We are working on a lot of different things now, building our careers, preparing our lives for the later years, stuff like that. So, we're at that place where we want to enjoy each other, enjoy our lives together, but also just continue to work on and build some of our goals and dreams. So, I'm looking forward to seeing some of those things realized, and I'm looking forward to sharing that with her. One of the best things about this is having someone to share everything with.
I am looking forward to seeing the next. What's next? You know, I'm excited that I have my traveling partner now. I love to travel.
We love to travel.
And if you've never been on vacation by yourself, which I have, it makes a big difference to have somebody that you can turn around to, like, hey, did you see that? Or let's do this. Or, you know, just share the memories with. When you go by yourself, it's like, it's for me, myself, and I. So I'm looking forward to seeing the world, having new experiences. Even the second time around, I've still had so many firsts, which sounds crazy, but I've had so many firsts with this man. And I'm just looking forward to many more. Yeah.
Love is the most important thing. You know, a lot of times people say a happy wife, happy life. I'm one that disagree with that, and to an extent that both of us need to be happy. And happiness comes with love. Two people loving each other the same. I guess Teddy Pendergrass said it when he was talking about how you know, if you love, you need the same person to love you back. So I agree with that part. So congratulations again. I love you both and thank God for you.
Thank you. Love you, man.
And the best of luck to the both of y'all. And may your lives be long, happy, and what you expect out of it. And to that, the best of luck and everything's in front of you. Go forward and get it. Thank you.
It has not been easy for you, man. But you have trusted God and you have allowed Him to bring you your best fits, and it's going to be amazing. We now all have a friendship for a lifetime. I'm so happy for you. You deserve this. Thank you.
I've watched you with eyes of love, hope, concern, joy, excitement, and tears. I've seen your willingness to pursue what was in your heart. I've watched you grow into a beautiful woman. I've even seen you in my departure. Your pain. But take heart. Oh, God. I'm sorry, y'all. But take heart. I was still watching over you. I've seen the struggles, but most importantly, I've seen your triumphs. I see you now in happiness, and I say live, love, and have joy. Because although in this day right now, I'm in the bosom of the Almighty, I still take a glance and I see you. If I could hug you and tell you I see you and that I'm proud of you and I give you congratulations for you and your husband as you both go forth in this next chapter, always, always, always remember, I see you and I love you and I'm with you, Mommy.
Remember this, laugh often, be silly, you are, have fun. Remember to say I love you before each day is done. And when you start each day, although we are apart from Mommy, remember this one thing always and keep it in your heart. A mother's love will never ever depart, and she will always be there in your heart.
Josh is one of my best friends. I've watched them for a long time interact with each other. And I think you got yourself a good woman. You got yourself a good man. And y'all know I'll be there. So I wish y'all all the best of luck. Many travels, trips, all that. Can't wait. Let's get it.
So when I saw you for the first time, it hit me. It hit me a little bit. I was like, this is real. Like, this is really real. We actually did this and we doing this. And like, you look so beautiful. Dolled all up. You know, I'm here for a doll up.
Yes.
I want her to be cute. And she was really cute. And I don't know, my heart just really felt a peace about it. Like, when I saw you come around the corner, I was like, that's my baby. I'm satisfied. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
You're a special person. And you deserve so much more than what you've gotten in life. And I vow to give it to you, girl. Every bit of it. Every good moment, every smile, every time that you wish that your man would show up and be there for you, I'm gonna be there for you, girl. Not me. So I'm honored and I'm proud, but I'm also committed today to build the life that we both always dreamed of. And I love you. I appreciate you loving me, honoring me, respecting me, watching your mouth, carrying yourself a certain type of way. Like, I appreciate those things. I really do. And as long as we can live together in that way of understanding, we can do this. I believe in us. So we're gonna go all the way. You hear me? We love y'all. We appreciate y'all. Thank you so much for coming out. And we're gonna have cutting up the cake, and then we're gonna party a little bit. Everybody enjoy yourselves. Thank you to everyone, and we appreciate you.
You're about the flyest thing that life could ever bring, like fresh air to me, the blood I bleed sent to me, and I wanna build with you. Softest cloud, a virgin.
vision in my eyes, an angel just my size. Wish that I could fall in love with you again, and I wanna be with you.
Thank everybody for coming out. It's been an amazing evening with y'all celebrating our life and love together.
Thanks so much. It was so much fun. Looking forward to what's next, man. We got a great, bright future ahead. I'm looking forward to it too, babe. Thanks to everybody who came out. It was great. See y'all around.
My way.